pornography is more prevalent than we'd like to know. Porn sites get more visitors each month, more than Netflix, Amazon, and Twitter combined. A third of all internet searches are porn. American children, on average, begin consuming hardcore porn at the age of 11 years old. A Google Trends analysis found that searches of teen porn has more than tripled between 2005 and 2013. That means it's not only teens on, but it's also adults looking for teens. Youth who look at violent X-ray material are 6 times more likely to report forcing someone to do something sexual online or in person as youth not exposed to X-rated materials. Psychological research over the past 30 years has absolutely demonstrated that watching violence is causal and correlational. It not only causes people to be more hostile and violent, it also desensitizes us to violence, makes us think more violently. Now that doesn't mean that every kid who plays video games is going to go out and kill people, right? But it does mean that it is changing our brains in the way we see things and the way we behave. We also have to worry about cybersecurity, hacking, phishing, scamming, adware, virusware. And finally, product marketing. Certainly there's money to be made on the internet. There's a reason that regulation isn't hitting it, because there's too much money to be made from it. And that's why every child of every age is being marketed regularly, almost constantly, on child websites. And finally, this is what I get most attention from the media is deception or inappropriate relationships and encouraging dangerous behaviors, things like pranks and also sexting. So here's a news report I did. I just did this one in March.
ABC 4's Journal Kevin Kleinbach also spoke with a psychologist today about how dangerous and how permanent those pictures can be. John.
Yeah, we talked about this a little bit last week. The Sheriff's Department announcing last week that they had made an arrest. 3 people involved in what they say was a human trafficking ring, and they thought that there might be more victims out there. And in all of that, the sheriff saying that he has noticed in some of their investigations with their own human trafficking task force is that some of those victims become victims because of the new selfies that they're posting online. So this warning goes out to parents and their kids to make sure you understand. 3 new cases today.
LA County Sheriff Jim McDonald, what he says is a growing trend. Kids taking nude selfies and those pictures ending up in the hands of child predators.
You can imagine the sophistication of a 9 or 10 year old is they're not gonna have a clue unless you talk to them and let them know that these things that are happening are not good.
The sheriff penned this open letter to parents over the weekend. The department says he had requested research on just how prevalent this was and was shocked by the results.
I don't believe that parents are aware of what their kids are doing online.
McDonald says his deputies have seen photos of kids as young as 8 years old uploaded to social media to someone they think is a friend. For the moment your child hits send, it's out of their hands and available online forever.
And this was one of the most concerning issues I've seen in 20 years of practice.
Dr. Tracy Bennett is a clinical psychologist specializing in teen exploitation. Her website, getkidsinternetsafe.com, shares stories and discusses the damage underage nude selfies can cause.
The damage is going to school not knowing who's seen that photo, not knowing if teachers know, not knowing if they're going to be arrested or in trouble, not knowing how much information is being farmed off their social media from potential predators.
The sheriff says some celebrities aren't helping the cause either. Kim Kardashian's post March 7th lit up social media, getting nearly 2 million likes and more than 300,000 comments.
People who have celebrity status, people who have the ability to influence the behavior of others, especially young people, I believe have an obligation to do so, eyes wide open, knowing that what they may do and do it for publicity will not have the same impact on a young child.
The sheriff's letter is 2 pages long, a lot of important information in all of that. The sheriff's saying that he wants parents to take a look at that, get some good information. He knows it's a tough topic for kids to perhaps bring up with their parents and for parents to talk with their kids. If you want to see the entire letter, you can go to our website, NBCLA.com, or check the NBCLA app. We're live in Sherman Oaks tonight. I'm John Candice Kleinbach, NBC 4 News.
All right, so the truth is that our kids are actually producing their own videos now, and they're producing their own photos. And parents just don't know. Parents just don't know. I'm hearing it in my office all the time. I'll have 15-year-olds who said they sent out their first nude at 11. They did it intentionally. They wanted to set their reputations and look sexy and sophisticated. The high school kids have access to the middle school kids now. And there's some predation going on where they pick the attractive My most popular article, unfortunately, is, "Hey Dad, your 12-year-old has a nude out, got thousands and thousands, tens of thousands of shares." And that's happening in our county among my clients. That was before the Nevada City, Canyon City built up, blew up when they found out their kids were doing it. All kids are doing it. And once they've released that, it gets re-released year after year after year, that same photo. And the boys will value those like Pokemon cards and keep them in collections and pass them. And so, you know, who knows who has them at that point. And it turns out that California's revenge porn law doesn't cover anybody who produced their own photo. It's only applicable if the photo was taken by somebody else. So once somebody is seduced into sending out those photos or do it on their own, which our teenagers are doing, then it's not even prosecutable for illegal dissemination. It's serious stuff, right? I mean, we really have to get serious about this. And cyberbullying is rampant. I won't go into that in detail because I'm certain most of you know a lot about that already. Recruitment into a cult or hate group, NBC in New York City contacted me on that because ISIS is so excellent at reaching teenagers intentionally, and so are other hate groups. And also access to sexual predators. So here's another one I did.
It's a crime against kids that the FBI and prosecutors say is growing very, very quickly. Online exploitation, also called sextortion. Anyone can become a victim, even in the privacy of your own home. Tonight, with school back in session, NBC4's Robert Kovacic has a warning for parents and their kids.
It was about a year that he had been watching me in my room.
Former Miss Teen USA Cassidy Wolf is a victim of sextortion.
It was just crazy, like a horror movie.
A former classmate tricked her into downloading hidden software, allowing him to control the camera on her computer.
And I just fell victim to it.
He took pictures of her while she was alone in her room, then demanded more.
And he would give like a countdown saying, "In 5 minutes, if you don't respond, I'm uploading all of this onto Facebook. And if I didn't respond or do as what he said, then he would ruin my life."
Fortunately, the FBI got involved and arrested Jared James Abrahams, who was released from prison today after spending just over a year behind bars.
I was just so damaged by it.
Kayla Laws was also hacked. A semi-nude photo she emailed to her Google account was stolen.
People do have this expectation of privacy.
The picture was uploaded to a revenge porn website, which would only remove the photo for a fee.
And it's really not all that different from traditional rape. You are exposed. You are vulnerable.
The men responsible were arrested and convicted. But police and prosecutors say as mobile devices, access to the internet, and social media increase, so do the predators.
And we're just seeing a great increase in the number of people who are willing to commit this crime.
Assistant U.S. Attorney Tracy Wilkinson sees the effect on victims firsthand.
It seems like they've been violated in the worst way.
Clinical psychologist Dr. Tracy Bennett says her practice is flooded with children in serious situations.
So as kids start social media younger and younger, they're at increasing risk.
After seeing her caseload explode, she created a toolkit for parents called Get Kids Internet Safe. She says one key for kids is having someone they trust that they can talk to.
I am very fortunate that my mom was involved and that my mom was there for me, because I don't know what I would have done if she wasn't.
Cassidy says she gets lots of messages from girls who are currently dealing with similar problems and offers this advice.
Yeah, I didn't see a light at the end of the tunnel. I only saw what was happening in the moment. But if I could go back and tell myself one thing, it's just to remember that things do get better with time.
Look, we're not going to stop people from taking naked pictures of themselves. They get to do that. But what I do think is that people should be thinking about where that might end up.
In San Juan Capistrano, Robert Kovacic, NBC4 News.
So I had an FBI agent tell me a couple days ago that within 10 years, the cyber division of the FBI will be the biggest division they have. It's that prevalent, and we're on it. But we just can't cover it quickly enough. And the good news is that having a really good quality relationship with your child will make a difference. I promise you it will make a difference. And that's one of the things that I'm very optimistic about. I see a lot of teenagers, I see a lot of kids, and when I talk directly to them about these things, they respond. And they change their habits. And they make better decisions. So I think, you know, by alerting you guys, if you start talking to them very frankly about this, it will change their outcome significantly. What surprised me the most when I started Get Kids Internet Safe, I thought that the most valuable tools I'd be giving people were the monitoring and filtering programs that I'd be trying out and recommending personally. And I do think they're useful, believe me. But after doing this for 3 years, I stand by what I've learned in all my life, really, but also in practice, and that is that it's really about relationships. That if we can form a good relationship with our teenagers and our young kids, and teach them skills, and not be afraid to talk to them about this really tough stuff, then they will have the skills they need to defend themselves when they come across stuff outside of our home, like the question that you were talking about. Kids really can make good decisions, but you have to teach them very specific skill building, and that means you have to talk about stuff that you don't think they're ready for. You can't wait to educate them about sex, for instance, when they're teenagers. We have to start providing real sex ed young, because otherwise they're entering it into their browsers and learning about it through porn. And you really don't want kids teaching kids about sex, right? Especially hardcore porn that isn't sex. That's not intimacy. That's destruction and it's violent. And we know that it damages children, just as trauma does. So we're going to filter and block them from that the best we can, but they're going to get to it sometime. And we need to prep them for that, right? We need to tell them how to handle that, what to do when they come across that thing so that they know that you're the person that they'll go to. If you sprinkle that stuff in to your everyday conversations once in a while, then it's not a forbidden topic. You don't have to have one birds and bees, you know, discussion that makes everybody miserable. You sprinkle it in here and there, and then they'll come to you and they'll talk to you about it. But that means we have to do really scary things that parents haven't done. And I survey my university students all the time about who's gotten sex ed and what kind of content they've gotten. Overwhelmingly, the girls get more than the boys. And the girls, it's primarily about menstruation and avoiding pregnancy. It's not about sex and sexual pleasure. And for boys, it's like, hey, son, just don't be stupid. That's pretty much all they get, right? And they need more than that because they're talking about it all the time. They're talking about it on social media. They're back-channeling it. They're sending each other links. And we need to be the people that help them with that. So I'm going to go through this fairly quickly because I want to start talking to you about specific strategies. And this is Tiffany. She's the girl I alluded to before. Now, I changed some of the details because of her confidentiality, but believe me, I have plenty of examples that I can mush into one, unfortunately. I've treated many victims of predators now. So when she came, she's 12. She's from a regular family, just like yours and mine. I have a private practice. It's fee for service. I treat everybody in town. And I treat people who love their children and whose children are well taken care of and supervised. But they're still getting into trouble because they're curious and they're smart. And they know how to manipulate. So she was involved with this 32-year-old predator from another state for 2 months before her parents figured it out. Called the police, the FBI got on it. He had multiple contacts with multiple young men and women, and was also friended on all of her social media, all of her friends' social media. So he was in contact with everybody, and a lot of her friends thought it was just this beautiful romance that they were having and supported it. So when we took her screen media access away from her, she probably spent another 2 months contacting him on the side through everybody else's screens. Even with psychotherapy, even with me, even when she found out that he was grooming multiple victims, even when I was meeting with her weekly and sometimes twice a week, it was very difficult. You know, she's in her 20s now. She's changed how she sees intimacy. She got into another pickle, even though I taught her everything I could, because it really laid down, you know, a very impactful learning experience for her.